When your sweet spot is not clearly defined, your business will exhibit symptoms that put stress on you and your team while eating away at your profit.
You're listening to the Profit by Design podcast, episode 68. You work hard in your business. On the Profit by Design podcast, we ask the big question: what has your business done for you lately? Hi, I'm Dr. Sabrina Starling, the business psychologist, the author of How to Hire the Best, and your co-host on the Profit by Design podcast. Weekly, my co-host, Mike Bruno, and I bring you tips, tools, and strategies from our own experiences and from the experiences of our guests who are entrepreneurial thought leaders and real-life entrepreneurs, all to support you in making intentionally profitable and sustainable business decisions to live the lifestyle you desire.
So, Profit Designers, we are continuing with end-of-year strategic planning here on the Profit by Design podcast. I am a huge, huge advocate for us getting more strategic as entrepreneurs. This is one problem I see over and over with the clients who come to us at Tap the Potential is there has not been enough attention on strategy in the business. We business owners get way too bogged down in the weeds of our business, doing the doing, and no one has an eye on the why of what we're doing and how we're going to be more effective and more strategic. So I really invite you to take the time here to engage in this end of year strategic planning because it's going to help you really have a much better 2020. So with that in mind, grab your notebook, grab your journal and your pen, and let's get going. I want to invite you now to vision 2020 for yourself. How will 2020 be? What is it that is going to make 2020 better for you? And most importantly, how do you want to experience 2020. This is not about doing more. This is not about increasing revenue. This is about you and you deciding what experience do I want to have in my life and in the business in 2020. And to support you in that, I'm going to ask you a powerful question. And in coaching, there is a specific type of powerful question, and we call it an inquiry. And an inquiry is one of those questions that is going to stick in your head, hopefully, and it's going to be something that you may not have an immediate answer to, but if you hold the question in your mind over the next week or so, you will have insights and aha moments around that question. So carry your journal, your notebook with you, and capture your insights and aha moments this week around this question. So I want you to imagine that it's December 31st and you're reflecting on your year. And you are so tickled pink with how the year has gone and how much success and joy and happiness you've experienced in 2020. So I'm asking you to imagine forward to December 31st, 2020, and you're reflecting on the year. It's been an incredible year. You've defined the experience that you wanted to have, and you've had that experience. Write down everything that has happened that has created that experience for you. Now, I invite you to start this question with your personal life rather than the business. On the Profit by Design podcast, we are always asking that big question: what has your business done for you lately? How has your business supported your quality of life? How has your business supported you in 2020 in creating an experience that you've wanted to have? Remember, work supports life, not the other way around. So think about your personal and spiritual growth. How have you grown in 2020? How did you improve your relationships in 2020? And what do you need to focus on to take your important relationships to the next level? Think about your personal finances and how you want to improve those. Think about your health. How did you improve your health in 2020? How are you sleeping? How well are you exercising daily? Are you getting enough exercise every day? Are you eating well? All of these things contribute to good health for us. Think about travel and experiences that you want to have. Think about your personal surroundings and the environment around you, your home, your office. How do those impact you, and what changes might you make in 2020 to improve those? These are all areas of our personal life to be considering and thinking about in 2020, December 31st, 2020. How did those things improve? What did we do? And I really invite you to write this down, not just sit here and reflect on it as I'm asking you the questions, but pause this and go off and write down your answers and see what comes up for you. And write in the present tense as if it is December 31st, 2020, and we are celebrating these wins for you together. Now, think about the different aspects of your business. Think about the profitability of the business. Think about the finances and the systems that you've put in place around the finances of your business. Think about the sweet spot of your business and how you want to improve the product and service delivery around your sweet spot in your business. Think about the systems you've put in place in 2020 that support the sweet spot of your business. Think about your team and what you want your team to be doing. Think about how the business has been an expression of your immutable laws. Now, don't get bogged down in the how during this exercise. And that's really important because our biggest pitfall is when we start creating a vision of what we want to experience and the success that we want to be celebrating December 31st, 2020, our mind naturally starts going to, well, I don't know how to make that happen. What am I going to do? How am I going to make this happen? Quiet those thoughts. Because that's going to interfere with your ability to really design a powerful vision for yourself. So what I'm going to take you through right now is looking at all the different aspects of your business that will support your business in being healthier and stronger, and that will give you a better and better quality of life. These areas that I'm taking you through are on our assessment at Tap the Potential. And you can access this assessment at tapthepotential.com/assessment. And I really encourage you to use our assessment as a strategic planning tool for yourself to see what you want to be intentional about working on in 2020. And if it's really important to you to have a business that is more sustainable, that gives you more life, that creates a better quality of life for your team members, and that is highly profitable, the areas on this assessment are the areas that you'll need to be paying attention to improving. And so as I go through these different areas of the assessment, I want you to think about, you have this in place in 2020. And really think from that perspective of, we have these things in place. So the very first area to consider is having a strong sweet spot in your business. Your sweet spot is the intersection of your top clients, your unique offering, and your process. A lack of quality leads, inconsistent sales, and poor quality clients are symptoms of an unclear sweet spot. When your sweet spot is not clearly defined, your business will exhibit symptoms that put stress on you and your team while eating away at your profit. So, how well defined is your sweet spot currently? You can take our assessment at tapthepotential.com/assessment and find out. And for your visioning for 2020, I want you to imagine that you have a strong sweet spot in place in your business. And what's going on when you have a strong sweet spot? You get to engage with wonderful clients that are a joy for you and your team to serve. You have a very clearly defined unique offering that positions you in the marketplace as unique. So you are not encountering as much price pressure, and you have strong systems in place that support the sweet spot. In my mind, when I think about those strong systems in place that support our sweet spot, I think about a peaceful, serene operating machine. That's my vision for 2020. Feel free to take that for yours too. Another area to consider in your visioning is profitability. Imagine it's December 31st, 2020, and you are celebrating that you've had the most profitable year ever in your business. And let's think through what needs to happen to make that occur. Remember, profit is the reward for the entrepreneurial risk that you bear. Profit is above and beyond what your business pays you to work in the business as an employee. After all, if we're really being honest, employees are not the ones who lose sleep at night worrying about the business's cash flow, but we business owners do, and we need to be rewarded for that. A business that does not have a system in place to guarantee strong profitability is one crisis or disaster away from closing its doors. In contrast, strong, consistent profitability increases the sustainability of our businesses and our businesses' ability to weather crises. Not to mention, strong profitability year over year increases the value of the business if we ever decide to sell it. So imagine it is December 31st, 2020, and you are tapping the full profit potential of your business. What is that like? You can take our assessment to look at the different areas that you need to be paying attention to make that happen. Imagine it's December 31st, 2020. And you have really strong systems in place in your business. Business and teams crave predictability. Strong systems bring about efficiencies that allow us to be more profitable in our businesses. Systems also free the business from being dependent on any one individual. And I'm going to tell you, I firmly believe that every team member in our business, including the business owner, deserves the opportunity to be able to be away from the business and their role be covered, meaning that you don't come back to a pile of work waiting on you that's built up while you were away. You're not having to scramble to get things done before you leave for a vacation. We need to be designing businesses that can operate independent of any one team member, including the business owner. That's a big part of the four-week vacation. Business owners who have strong systems and a great team in place are well positioned to take a four-week vacation or simply just be away from the business to pursue other interests or take care of things in your family that need your attention. So imagine it's December 31st, 2020. And your business is able to operate without you and other team members in critical roles for an extended period of time. What is that like? Next, we need to look at your leadership. In small business, our culture is a direct reflection of us as the owner. We all have blind spots, and the struggles that we have to build harmonious, highly engaged teams grow directly from our personal blind spots as the leader. I know that's bad news, that's hard to hear, but it's the reality. The best of us crave opportunities to learn, to grow, and receive ongoing feedback on our leadership. So imagine it's December 31st, 2020. You have uncovered critical blind spots that had been holding you back in 2019. You have done things to address those blind spots, and the business has grown by leaps and bounds because of that. And if you're curious what your blind spots might be, take our assessment at tapthepotential.com/assessment. That tool is designed to shed light on what you may be overlooking for yourself in your leadership and in how you're running the business. Next, I want you to imagine it's December 31st, 2020, and you have built a top-performing team. You have great A players who work together harmoniously, and you have systems in place for building that high-performing team. You no longer feel like you're constantly having to scramble to cover open positions. You have your How to Hire the Best A player attraction system in place. You have A player team members who are working well together to create this highly profitable, great place to work. You have systems for efficiently recruiting and retaining talent. And just beyond recruiting and retaining talent, you have highly engaged team members in the right seats in the business, working from their strengths with clearly defined performance targets that support the team's mission and goals. Let yourself really embrace that vision for a moment and experience what that would be like to imagine that in the critical roles in your business, you have A players. They are working from their strengths. Everyone has a result that they're responsible for delivering. And you are no longer the hub of the business because of that. And not only that, you get to do the work that you most enjoy in the business because you have been strategic in identifying your strengths. So I hope going through these critical areas and creating a highly profitable, great place to work have given you some facts and details to help you flesh out a really strong vision for the business for 2020. What do you want to move forward and accomplish? And I also want to invite you to really zero in on what would have the greatest impact for you on the experience that you want to be having as the owner of the business. Identify what that experience is. Myself personally, I want peace and joy. I want to feel peaceful about my business in 2020. And when I show up at work, I want to feel joy because I am getting to do the things that I love doing the most in the business when I choose to be doing them. I want to make sure that I have peace of mind that if for some reason I'm not able to be at work for a given day or a given week, that the critical functions of the business are continuing to hum along without me. That is my vision for 2020. So I want to hear for you what experience you want to be having in your business in 2020, and what are you going to be putting in place to make that experience happen? And again, if you need some help thinking through what are the critical things that you're going to put in place to make that experience happen, use our assessment at tapthepotential.com/assessment to prompt your thinking on that. Next week, I want to take you through life planning. At Tap the Potential, we are all about work supports life, not the other way around. And just as it's important to be planning your vision for success in the business in 2020, I want to take you through a process that will help you plan your vision for a great life in 2020.
Thank you for spending time with us today. Join our conversation in the Profit by Design podcast Facebook group. Share your thoughts on today's episode, ask us questions, and let us know what you want to hear about next. Visit our website at profitbydesignpodcast.com to access resources from our sponsors and tools we've created for you. Subscribe to the show on whatever platform you're listening to right now. There's a subscribe button right there. Go ahead and hit it so that you always get a notification when we release a new episode. And finally, share our podcast with a friend if you know a friend who would enjoy it. Thanks again for listening. This is real life business. Keep your chin up. Keep moving forward. You got this.